Yes, U value, please pay attention. This is a very important topic because you can do the exercise based on this. So I'll just read out the definition. U value is the measure of overall heat transfer by the mechanism under standard condition through a particular section of construction. It can be wall, it can be roof, particular section of construction. And it is a measure of overall heat transfer, or it is conductance value. The heat that is flowing from outside to inside or inside to outside. The heat that is transferring a material, it is transferred of in a material is nothing but it is, it can be expressed by U value. In other words, U value is used to measure how well or how badly a component transmits heat from outside to inside or inside to outside. The slower or more difficult it is for heat transfer through the component, the lower the U value. This means that we are looking for a lower U value. We means people who are in, usually we can say hot climate, okay, or even in cold climate also they are looking for lower U value, okay. It is only in moderate climate they can go for a higher U value, okay. Or you can say the wall which is facing north side should have higher U value, okay. So basically we want a lower U value. It means it should allow less heat transfer. Yes, lower U value means less heat transfer, higher U value means more heat transfer. The lower the value, the better. When we talk about a component, we can mean pane glass, doorway. Okay. Now, R value is opposite of U value. U value is thermal transmittance, the heat allowed, the heat that is passing through. R value is nothing but resistance. Okay. The resistance is nothing but it is stopping the heat. Okay. So, in equation also, U value is equal to 1 by R value. Please note this down. Sorry, R value is nothing but thermal resistance and U value is nothing but thermal transmittance. Now resistance is opposite, where U value is, okay. Resistance is equal to, I think please note this down, resistance R, which is represented by R, resistance, is equal to dimension of the layer measured in meters. Now dimension of the layer, it means what is the thickness of that material, okay, or depth of the wall, okay. Let's say if it is a brick wall, it is a stone wall, what is the thickness and conductivity of that particular material. Resistance is equal to dimension or depth divided by conduction. Conductivity is nothing but a physical property where let's say iron has more conductivity, and that is a physical property of the material. How closely the molecules are binded with each other, we can say that is, it is having more conductivity. Yes. If a material which has molecules very tightly packed, then it will have more conductivity. If it is loosely packed, then it is having less conductivity. Yes. Resistance is equal to depth of or dimension of the layer measured in meters divided by the conductivity. Yes. Now this thermal resistance, like thermal resistance is cumulative. That is, let's say here there is one wall, there is cavity, there is let's say brick wall and another black basalt wall. Now I said I wanted black basalt wall inside, so I'll use black basalt wall inside and I'll use like let's say another brick wall and I'll leave a cavity and I may be another brick wall or a stone wall something from outside. Let's say outside, from outside I can make people look like it is a stone building or an RCC building or these things, but whereas from inside I can have, okay. And I can use in thin layers because the material is changing, the thermal resistance is changing. And it is also leading because of the cavity and the change in material, the heat is cut down. Yes, because of these materials, let's say clay or brick wall and let's say cavity, that is cut down. Okay, now here it is represented by R3, RA, R1 and RI. RI may be like inside, okay. SO, okay, thermal resistance of outer wall is SO. This is inside wall, this is outside wall. And these are the different layers of wall. Okay. Now total thermal resistance is equal to adding all these things. Okay. Now thermal resistance of this wall, the complete wall, is nothing but is equal to RSO plus R3 plus RA plus R2 plus R1 plus RSI. Whatever the total resistance is nothing but it is simple, the total resistance. U value is also nothing but U value is U value of outer wall, U value of 3, U value of air, U value of 2, U value of 1 and U value of the innermost wall, innermost layer it will be like total U value of this thick wall. Okay. Now thermal conductivity, we can see, we can list out, there are different materials and there are different organization, like NBC has given some standards, ECBC has given some standards, they have done some tests and they have found out what is the thermal conductivity of this particular material. Okay. Now let's say brick, please note down brick, some important materials, like let's say brick, note down thermal conductivity is 0.84. Please note down the thermal conductivity of brick is 0.84. Yes. Now see, concrete also, dense concrete is 1.4, whereas aerated concrete slab, aerated, which is having, which is porous and which has lot of air, which has a porous material, so that has very less conductivity. It is having 0.16 conductivity watt per meter Kelvin, and then the concrete is having 1.4 conductivity. Yes. And you can say gypsum board or plaster gypsum board, it is having 4.6. roof tiles, yes, roof tiles, which is having 0.85. you can say roof tiles is having 0.85. timber or wood, it is having 0.14. okay. Or you can take a picture of this, you can take a picture of this or a screenshot of this. If you are seeing on the phone, you can just take a screenshot of this, or you can take a picture of this. Okay. I just want you to note down maybe bricks, that is 0.84, and a plaster gypsum board, that is 0.46. yes. And extended or expanded polystyrene, this is expanded, there is also extruded polystyrene, which is, this is usually used as, polystyrene is usually used as insulating material. Okay. Now you can see the thermal conductivity of this material, which is less, very less. Okay, please note down this expanded polystyrene, yes, it is 0.032 to 0.040. okay, you can note down it as 0.040. okay, please note down the conductivity of polystyrene, the conductivity of gypsum board, plaster gypsum board, and also bricks. Yes. Okay, now these three materials. Yes. Now we know that U value is nothing but 1/R. Okay, you already noted this down, that U value is nothing but 1/R. Now you need to calculate what is the R value. Yes, to know what is U value, you can know R value based on this. Yes. So let's consider a wall which is having, now this is one last thing. Yes. One example where there is U value of two materials which is having U value of 0.3 watt per meter square Kelvin, and another is 0.6 watt per meter square Kelvin. Yes. So this is having U value of 0.3, and another is having, wall 2 is having U value of 0.6. okay. So it means that the heat transfer is double in, yes, the wall 2, which is having U value of 0.6. so lower your U value, less heat transfer, more U value, which means more heat transfer. Yes. Wall with U value of 0.3 will lose heat at half rate of low wall 2, which has U value of, it will either heat, lose heat or gain heat, both the way, if it is from inside to outside, outside to inside, whatever. So the heat transfer is happening at certain rate. If the U value is double, if it is more, let's say 0.6, then the heat transfer is double, then in this case. Okay.